Hello everyone, Mad News from Madness's Adult Hub here, and I'd like to welcome you all back to Life is Strange 2. This is it, guys. Second to last episode, and man, it has been a ride. I have been so stoked sharing these games with you guys. Like, I know usually, like, the whole big thing is to play what's popular, but I couldn't help myself. I had to play these games for you guys, and now it's almost done. So I think I've honestly ultimately decided to go through and do the videos of every ending. I know it'll take... Are you done, ma'am? Sorry, the bird is going off behind me. Anyway, I think I've ultimately decided to go through and do videos for every ending. So what it'll entail, for the first Life is Strange and for Life is Strange Before the Storm, I will put their different endings in with the collectibles, because both of those games only have one collectible and one other ending option. So you guys will see the collectibles and then the what would have happened if we picked this. For True Colors and Life is Strange 2, however, they both have different endings, with Life is Strange True Colors having about 6 different endings, or maybe it's like 9 different endings, because it depends on if you romance Ryan, if you romance Steph, and then whether or not you choose to leave or stay. So it's like 6 different endings. And then if you don't choose to romance either, you can get the 2 endings of leaving or staying, of just by yourself. If you don't be quiet, I'm putting you in the cage. Talking to the bird. So it's like 9 different endings for True Colors that all depend on the romance that I can show you guys. So that'll be its own video because of how many endings there are, as well as its collections, which is the memories. And then for Life is Strange 2, there's like 7 different endings you can get, because one of the 6 endings has a little bit of a variant, which I'm hoping is the ending we'll get for this game, but we'll see. So it'll have its own endings video, as well as its collectibles, because this game has about 3 different things you can collect. You have the drawing spots, you have the keychains, and, I think there's one more. I think there's, like, the stickers or something. So, yeah, so Life is Strange 2 and True Colors will have their own collection videos and episode ending videos, whereas Life is Strange and Before the Storm will have their collector's videos mixed in with their opposite ending videos, if that makes sense. But anyways, you know, with all that being said, it will take time for those videos to go out, because I have to play through the game for each ending. So, for example, for Life is Strange 2, in this case, we have the option to get one of 2 endings at the end of the game. And then I can go through, and as part of the video, I can just pick the other ending and put it in the video. But then, to show you guys the other endings, I have to go through and play through the whole game again, because the endings are based on your interactions with Daniel. And then the same thing for True Colors, it depends on whether you romance or not. So I could go through for True Colors, and because we already had the one ending where we stayed with Steph, I could go through and I could show what happens if you leave with Steph, but then I have to go through and play the game again to romance Ryan, and show what happens if you leave or stay with Ryan, and then I have to go through and show what happens if you don't romance anyone and then you leave or stay. So it'll take a bit of time for those episodes to kind of come out, at least for Life is Strange 2 and True Colors, but I'll get them done. So with all that being said, just give me 1 second. Alright, so with all that out of the way, I think it's time we go ahead and hop into this and we finish what we've already started. We should be on episode 4. Things are about to get kind of serious, you know, we're about to encounter some new characters, and then for the final episode, a little bit of a returning character. So let's just hop right into it. I'm so excited. Ah! I love these Life is Strange games. I hope another one comes out soon. I have games that are similar to Life is Strange I want to play for you guys. I just have to be able to get them. I've never played them before, so it'll be nice to start doing games I haven't seen before, so then it's more of like, oh, I'm reacting to this thing happening, rather than, oh, I already know what's going on here.
Once upon a time, in a wild, wild world, there were two wolf brothers living in their home lair with their papa wolf. They lived in peace until hunters took their dad away. And they had to go on the run. That's when the big brother discovered that the little one was not an ordinary wolf, but a super wolf. They discovered a secret hideout where they could train day and night. They were happy. But the little wolf got very sick, and they had to move on. The brothers made it to the home of their ancestors, and the old wolves took care of them. Unfortunately, the hunters were hot on their trail and found them. The brothers had nowhere to stay again, so they decided to keep going south. They soon entered the old forest of the giants, where they met a pack of stray dogs who worked in a secret farm. The brothers joined them and worked hard to stock up on gold for the future. They were happy to find others like them, and everybody loved the little wolf, who was growing up fast. His power was growing too. The little wolf was more and more confident and independent. The big brother hooked up with a cool she-dog. They had their own adventures. Suddenly, the mean farmers who owned the land tried to hurt the brothers. The little cub was injured. He transformed into a super wolf and destroyed everything. The big brother was badly wounded. And worse, he didn't know where the little cub was.
Biggest thing I love about these games is how they started to develop more into like a your choices affect the things around you type of thing. With the various different endings and all that. This one was heavy on it. Your choices affect Daniel's morality, which affects which ending you get. Cause yeah, you in the end you only have one of two choices. But you can still get up to, like, six different endings based on Daniel's morality, and then an extra variant of an ending based on whether or not you've contacted your friends, like Lila. Because one of the variants is where Lila shows up, only if you've called her both episodes, where you have the opportunity.
Hey, Sean. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. It was a bad idea.
Daniel. No way. It's all good.
Wish I listened when you tried to stop me from going with Finn. I was too pissed.
It's okay, dude. You're my brother. And that's all that counts.
So, why don't you come and get me? I'm alone, Sean. I don't know what to do. I'm scared.
Don't get so close to that edge.
Please, come and get me.
Yes, I swear.
Marcus, wait.
Stop!
Oh, I forgot about that dream. Whew! I forgot that dream happens. Okay. Two months?
Fuck. Daniel. I keep having these nightmares and can't even focus on the page. This sucks ass, man.
Blind and effed and in police custody, going to jail soon. Hospitals freak me out. Hate this. Where's Daniel? I'm scared. Tried to draw to kill time. This poem is like a cage, but I suck now. No depth perception, no apt. I'm sure I can't find Daniel after the explosion, so he's out there alone. Happy birthday, Daniel, wherever you are. Claire and Steven sent me a nice letter, so lonely I needed it. It's hard to read this because he can't really write very well. Wish I could hear Cass play again, all those songs when... They have Daniel up. I let Finn become his brother. Aww.
Can't catch shit. Zero depth perception. Goodbye, sports. Yeah. Thanks for the card, Agent. Can't wait to text you. This must be my punishment.
Oops.
Ugh, can't even focus on the page. Yay. Stupid reality shows.
Oh, there it is.
I miss Cass so much.
Howdy, city boy.
Wish I could
hold
her.
Bet you're surprised to hear from me. I found out we were in the same hospital from the police after we were questioned when I was checked out a month ago. So I took the chance to write and hope you get this. Wish I could say everything I want, but you know who's reading. You never know who's reading, right? If anybody else is reading this, F you. I truly hope you are okay after what happened. As for me, I don't remember much except the explosion at Merrill's office. Then I woke up in the hospital with blunt trauma, healing, and what the doctors call blast lung injury, hurting. Just glad that I can still play guitar and sing, not that I feel like it. You learn a load about medicine stuck in a hospital bed. As I'm sure you know, my sweet compadre, still working on that Espanol, miss my lessons and my teacher. You probably know more about what's going on than me, but Hannah, Penny, and I were released without charges. The police were stoked to bust a farm of drug traffickers rather than us gutter punks trolling in the field. We asked about you and Daniel, but got no answers. Surprise. So with Finn and you gone, our rail family is kind of broken up. Now we're just a lonely trio, train hopping up and down the state. But it feels like we're going in a loop to nowhere. Hannah and Penny aren't the same, and we fight too much. I'm not even sure we'll be together for much longer. Stuff changes, right? Maybe I'll have a whole new set of blues songs for the road. I know you're going to trial soon over the Seattle situation, and you will get the justice and freedom you deserve. You and Daniel are amazing brothers, and I hope you find your way home soon. I hope we can swim again under a new moonlight. It's a big world, and maybe we'll meet again someday. I'll always be singing your song. Love and peace, Cassidy. Aww.
Glad Steven's leg is better. Must be tough on Claire.
Sean, we are grateful to find out that you are safe and awake. The police contacted us when you were found unconscious in Humboldt County. We weren't allowed to visit you in the hospital, but we want you to recover ASAP. The doctors say that you woke up from that coma stronger than before. The most important thing now is to find Daniel. We are helping the police any way we can. They really want to help him find him too, Sean. Hopefully this reflects well during your trial. We know this must be hard for you after everything you and your brother have been through. You're both in our thoughts and prayers every day and night. Remember, you are family and we love you. We hope to visit you and Jolina Shore as soon as we can. Take care, Claire and Steven. P.S. Kristen insisted to write a little note. It's attached to this letter. P.P.S. He doesn't know Daniel is missing.
Don't know if we'll ever come back, Chris. Miss that little superhero.
Hi, Sean and Daniel. I hope you are okay. I am fine, but I miss both of you a lot. When are you coming back? Dad has been better lately. He says hello and we are fishing now that summer is here. We do a lot of stuff outside now. All the snow is gone. You should come back to see Beaver Creek without the snow. I will be waiting for you. Chris and Captain Spirit. P.S. We need to save Beaver Creek from swamp bugs. Aww.
Can't catch shit. Zero depth perception. Goodbye. Joey must hate the sound of this thing.
Yo. Afternoon checkup.
Sure.
Hey, Joey.
Good day, sunshine.
Hey, Joey. Hey, man.
That looks like it might have been food. Hard to tell.
Ha ha. Never heard that before.
Oh, somebody is in a bad mood.
Sorry, Joey. Not feeling it today.
I don't blame you. But maybe I got something to cheer you up.
Pecans and chocolate?
Uh-oh. There's that smile.
Thanks, Joey.
So how you feeling today? Any headaches? Socket pain?
No. It's all good.
Well, this is your final test before... you know. Before they... check you out.
Check me out to juvie. Yeah.
Okay, let's see. You know the drill. Don't blink and just stare at the light. Yes. Nice retina response. Okay. Now, try to follow the light as well as you can. Come on, Sean. You've been there before. Good, good. Keep going. Quick response. Nice. Remember, to see objects on your left side, you gotta turn your head more now. Yes. Looking good, Sean. Now try to align your pen with mine.
I'll try.
No rush. This is tough. Your depth perception will always be affected, so you gotta try harder.
Shit.
Yeah, I know. It's hard.
Come on.
Yeah, that's enough. Too much stress on you and your eye. But remember, your depth perception will always be affected. Here, read this.
Get me out of here. Please, Joey.
Sean, I want to help you, but that's not my job. You can try. But you can't rig the exam, Sean. It's time we release you. Sorry. Your vision has improved a lot. Now you don't really have severe side effects anymore.
Yeah. That's just great.
I do have to tell them the truth. But first, let's clean this dressing.
Hey, sure hope you're watching the door like your phone. Oh,
come on. He ain't going nowhere.
Great.
All I do is watch him.
Yes, true. Your job.
Do you mind if we talk alone?
Mind if I finish with my patient?
He looks good for now, right? Just come back when I'm finished with
him. Get out of here, woman.
Sure.
You can't just make a doctor leave his patient.
I'll swing by later, Sean. Stay cool.
She's so entitled, I swear. Like, not, like, you don't know her very long. But just in that one moment, it's like, why, you're making the doctor leave
so,
him.
How are you feeling today,
when your
Mr. Diaz?
Amazing. Did you find Daniel?
I want to go over this again.
What? I've been telling the same fucking story for 3 weeks. How much longer?
Until it makes sense. Until you get it right. So, silence isn't gonna help you now.
Get it right.
Listen close, Sean. Tomorrow you're going to Jolena Shore and you'll be arraigned in court for the murder of a Seattle police officer. You might spend the rest of your life in prison, or you can talk to me.
I didn't kill anyone. The end.
So, who did? You do know.
It's just, I can't.
Was Daniel involved? Is that why you can't talk?
No, no way.
And you're absolutely sure your dad didn't go after the officer?
Yeah, he came outside. Then he was killed. That's what he did. Just guilty of being, who knows?
I hear you, but you're sure you didn't get upset and go after the officer? It happens.
Jesus, no. Look at me.
Okay, let's just jump ahead. Tell me what happened in that farm in Humboldt. The place looks like a tornado wiped it out.
I've told you so many times. I have no clue why the place was trashed. I passed out.
Plus 3 seriously wounded, along with you. And a missing child. Nobody's statement matches with each other. Sean, throw me a bone here. Can't you see I want to help?
So you haven't found my brother?
We might have some leads. You can help by telling me the truth.
Okay. Fuck.
The robbery. Whose idea was it? His?
Finn's.
Or yours? Huh?
Finn. It was his idea to rip off Mero.
Did he force you to help? Or did you go along with it?
He lied. I didn't want to help, but he got Daniel involved. I swear. Swear I didn't think anything like this was gonna happen.
Nobody does, Sean. Until it's too late.
Yeah. Now I know.
And what about Cassidy? She planned all this with Finn?
She was against this stupid plan. She had nothing to do with it.
Your friends are learning the hard way.
They didn't deserve it. We all make mistakes.
Yeah, well, some mistakes are worse than others. By the way, we contacted your grandparents in Beaver Creek. They can visit you after you're transferred. Might be a while, but you do have a support group. We couldn't track down your mother, though. Sorry.
Good. What about Daniel? You said you had leads.
I said might. Hold on. I gotta take this call.
Yeah, get out of here.
Sorry, Finn. She didn't want anything to do with this.
Everything okay?
Wonder what Meryl told the cops about the robbery. Sorry, Hannah. She lost. Hope the cops didn't mess with Penny. Prison would fuck him up. Sorry, Finn. Wonder what. Sorry, Hannah. She lost her family for this.
Yeah, sorry, Finn, but
no.
I know she's trying to help, so I can give her as much of the truth as possible, but God. All of this, the whole thing is so messed up. Like, it shouldn't have even happened in the first place.
Sorry about that.
Okay. So what's going on with Daniel? You really have leads?
Yes, we do. That's our job. The Bureau put his profile out over 4 states. So we are on the case.
For how long? It's been over 2 months. How are you gonna find him?
We have a lot of people looking for your brother. Trust me. We want to find him too.
Yeah, yeah. So you can lock him up too, right? Whatever.
Anyway, thanks for talking to me. I'll be back tomorrow to take you to Jolina Shore.
Look out. I have to guard the guard now. Love it. Sit down so we can get this show going. So, how did your interview with Scully go?
You mean interrogation? Who knows? Maybe Detective Flores wants to help. Maybe not. I just can't trust her.
After what you and your brother went through, I don't blame you. Aw, this shit is all wrong, man. You've been out of the garden for 3 weeks now. We talk every day. I can see that you're a good person.
Thanks, Joey. Want to tell that to the judges?
I'm just saying, you don't deserve this. Now let's check this out. The healing is coming along nice. Just gotta keep it clean for the next week or so. Simple.
That's great.
Seen the shrink this morning? What did she say?
Nothing I want to hear. This will take time and rehab, Sean. You have to process first. Ugh. I could tell myself that shit.
Clearly, I'm no therapist, but I've nursed patients with your injury. They all turned their anger into energy. You will too. Plus, the glass eye tech is pretty cool now. Things change, huh?
Yeah. Stuck in jail is a big change. Can't wait. Sorry, Joey. I'm being a dickhead. Just bummed out.
I know. I do. But I promise there's a treat coming your way. Now, as for your wound, this is the last time you hear this from me. You have to clean it with sterile gauze and saline solution. Coat the area using the swab and cream. Then wrap it up with clean dressing. And you're the shit. Remember, you gotta do this.
4 times a day. I won't forget.
I'm sorry about everything, Sean. Wish I could have done more.
Dude, you saved my ass here. You're the only one I trust. It really helped.
Cool. I'm glad when I can make a ch- Oh, shit. Emergency. I'm out. And no smoke break. Let's say our goodbye tomorrow. Oh, Sean, check out that towel. Got your name all over it. Catch you later.
Check out the towel. Joey is freaking awesome. I wish I could keep him longer.
Joey, you are her boss. What? Wow.
Haven't seen you in a long time.
The drawing book?
I know I fucked Daniel over. Again. And now he's gone. Where would he hide out? A 10-year-old by himself? Out there? He might go back to Seattle. But too far. Nowhere to go. If he tried to hook up with Claire and Steven, they would have definitely told me. Or the cops. Wait. What's that? Super Wolf? Huh? Does that mean... It means that Daniel... Daniel's with Jacob somewhere? He's safe? I could see him again.
I borrowed a blanket and a few other things from your tent. We'll give them back to you when you come looking for your Super Wolf comic. It's waiting for you, Jake.
Haven Point, Nevada.
Had a long talk with Jacob. He's a little kid. He's lived in some religious commune from Haven Point, Nevada. Nevada looks fine here. Free?
I gotta get to him. I gotta find a way to escape. Tonight. Okay. Time to clear off now. This whole hospital is so quiet. So don't make any noise. And find a way to get the hell out of here. Wish I could just... walk out. Sweet dreams, my friend. Maybe I can trick him. Say I need an aspirin or something. Let's see. I just gotta get past that locked door and an angry guard. Can I have some privacy, please?
So, there's a few different ways we could do this. And, yeah, I know what my objections are.
Oh. Nada. Joey could probably distract the guard dog.
I want to try to see if Joey will help. Because I know there's a chance for Joey to help you. You just have to have made the right choices while you're talking with him. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah. Thanks for the card, Agent. Can't wait to text you. Joey's the only one who helped me get through this shit.
You got business in there?
Patient called. Just gotta see what our boy needs.
Good. I need a smoke break.
Hey, that's your job. Go for it. Hey, there's my second favorite patient. Gotcha.
You never stop working, Joey.
I'm doing a double night shift. Diane is out with a flu, so lucky me. Yeah, I'm fried. But that sweet, sweet overtime. Sean, you look stressed. You feeling okay?
Yeah, I know where my brother is.
What? How?
I found a note in the sketchbook you brought me. He's in Nevada. With, a friend of ours.
Fuck, Sean. That's awesome. Now that's good news. Nevada sucks, but at least the kid is safe.
Listen, Joey. I need to get out of here.
What? Come on, Sean. You know I can't let you do that. You know I'm on your side, man.
Please, Joey.
I don't blame you for being scared. You're leaving tomorrow. But don't fuck around with this. You hear me?
Gotta make the right choices here.
Joey, I'm so scared. I've never felt like this. Like, I'll be in jail for life, and I'll never see Daniel again. I can't do it, man.
I hear you, man. I swear, that kills me to see you in that situation, Sean, but you really want me to help you break out of here. So what happens to me? I lose my job, go to jail. I have a girlfriend, a rent to pay, a future.
Sorry. I'm sorry, Joey. I was being selfish. I want to help my brother. It's all I can think about. He's 10 years old. And out there, all alone. He needs his big brother.
Sean, I wish I could help you. I swear, but I can't do this.
Joey, please.
Look, it's not fair to ask me to give up my job and my life. To maybe, possibly help you escape?
I know. I'm just desperate.
Let's forget about this, okay? I'll do anything else I can to help. Now, I really gotta get back to my shift. I'm tired already.
Dang it. Pretty sure there's a chance for him to help you. I just don't know what options to pick to do that. All right.
You have a good night, Doc.
Oh, the souvenirs, I forgot. We're getting out of here.
Too bad this isn't a movie. Can't even fit. Need a superhero to open that shit. Hope my last view of this world isn't this window. It's dead tonight. Works for me. One stupid car. And I'm out of here.
Or wait.
I could climb down the side of the building. Or die trying.
Not that I can get out the window.
Can't open that window with my bare hands.
I don't think there's anything around here to even use to open it. So am I really gonna have to lure the guard in here?
The windows are secured. But who knows? This one isn't screwed in. I could... Let's do it.
Hey! What the hell are you doing in there?
Nothing you need to know.
Nice job, Sean. Now the guard is awake and pissed off.
Anybody, because the only other option is to get the guard to come in the room and then freaking hit him with the grab bar.
This is Gracie, dude. Don't freak out. Just get out. Don't think. Just keep going. Holy shit. Oh. Take a breath, dude.
There goes my joystick drift there to try to move Sean forward.
Way too close. Time to get my shit from the staff room.
Who just leaves that window open?
Okay. Guard is sleeping. This is your big chance, dude. That's Finn. No way. What is he doing here?
Don't. Just go. You turned him in. If you wake him up, he'll probably turn you in for escaping. So just go. another day, another day. This is how we do it now. Try to do things without people getting hurt. Sorry, Joey. We love you, man. Driving alone in my, I don't know. I thought that was like a song, but I couldn't think of any words. Probably wouldn't even notice him missing until morning because the guard was sleeping, and I assume the staff would assume that you're sleeping. Out of there.
Guess this is my room for the night. She seems nice. Sorry I stole your car, guys. Shit. Guess I fucked up her day pretty bad. Fuck. My eye's itchy. I should probably clean it before I doze off. Careful. Man, I should have listened to Joey. This is a mess. Shit. It will never hold until Haven Point. Guess I'm kind of lucky I stole a smoker's car. Okay. Haven Point is straight ahead. Just a few more hours' drive. Come on. Did she interview everyone in that hospital? Or what?
Oh, it was left in the car then. That's okay.
What a mess. Floaters can now add Grand Theft Auto to my file.
Still with me, Sean?
Yeah. Just zoning out.
Just don't do that when you're driving, my son. So, what's the verdict on the new car? I know it's not a new board, but it's got four hot wheels.
Thanks for finishing it, Dad.
A perfect reward for your excellent report card. I'm proud, Sean. You don't even bullshit me when you need cash. And I'll try to be cool. No dad jokes, huh? I hope you're not too bummed out to go on a big road trip with your lovely papito, huh?
Oh, please. You're the coolest dad. How could I be bummed?
Excuse me. Where's my regular, emotionless son? I appreciate it. Think we can hang out for 5 days without killing each other?
Hell yeah. Haven't done that since I was a kid. Miss it.
So do I. Been too long since we went padre y hijo against the road.
Way too long. I love road trips.
Good to hear. By the way, boy talk. What's going on with that gin, huh?
Well, not much to talk about.
That was like pulling teeth. Well, I've got a week to find out the truth.
It's just, I don't get to see her too much. Kinda miss her.
Oh, you're hooked, my son. Don't worry. This is how it goes. Ah, could that be Daniel? Hola. Hello. Everything okay, Lila? Oh, Daniel better not be giving you any sass.
Nah, he's an angel. We went to the swimming pool, and now we're making popcorn.
The one I wish I could romance with, Sean.
It's so cool. Hey, Sean, don't crash the car.
He's driving real slow and safe, like a grandma. Thanks for checking in. We'll buzz you when we hit the motel.
Lila, you ready? Sounds good. And Sean, Jen wants you to call her when you have time.
Jen says hi. Sounds pretty good, Sean.
You think? Maybe.
Seriously, though. How are you
really doing?
I guess
they're more like brother and sister, so maybe not a, maybe not Sean and
it's
Lila.
It's stupid, but I miss you.
I miss you too, my son. But this is all part of growing up.
I know. I don't like it.
I have total faith in you, Sean. You're a Diaz. You were born to roam and find your way home.
God, I love you, Dad. Wish I would have told you more.
You didn't have to tell me. You showed me. Oh, by the way.
Hey, wake up!
Huh? Huh? What?
Yeah, what the fuck are you doing on our property?
Huh? Oh, man, I crashed hard.
Oh, yeah? Come on out, boy. Who the fuck is that? A fucking kid. Get out.
Look, I'm leaving, okay?
No, you ain't. Step out, or I'll call the cops. You don't want that boy.
Okay. I'm coming. Hold on.
Good. Now we can see you. So tell us what the fuck you're doing on our land.
I drove for so long, I had to pull over to get some rest, you know? I swear, I had no idea this was your property.
There's a fucking sign. Didn't you see it?
I was too exhausted. I guess I missed it.
He's just a kid, and he's hurt. Look.
Yeah? What happened to your eye?
I got into an accident.
Oh, yeah? Uh-huh. Move it.
Please, I just want to go.
Oh, what's this? Drugs?
Yeah, for my eye.
Oh, yeah. Did you steal them? Like this car?
Listen, it's not what you think.
Oh, I think it is. You ain't the first beaner we caught. Take his backpack.
Dude, come on.
Get it. Let's see what he's holding. So?
Nothing good.
Any money?
Fucking toys, man.
You still play with toys? Seriously?
It belongs to my brother! Leave it alone!
Whoa! You did not! That's it, boy. Get up. Up!
Okay, Chad. We fucked with him. Let him go. He's got nothing.
Hey. Hold on a sec, Mike. You speak Spanish, Pedro?
Huh? What?
What? Hablas español.
Chad.
So, Professor, how do you say, I'm a dirty thief?
Don't do this.
Oh, you don't want to share your language? Okay. Maybe you know this one. I'm a dirty thief with one eye.
No, just stop, please.
Figures. You come here to steal, but don't want to give back. All I want to do is learn Espanol. Might be our official language someday, right? Si, senor? So, one more lesson. How do you say, this is not my country?
I don't know. Told you.
Well, that's the only one you should know, boy. Learn it.
Look, Chad, it's gonna rain. Let's go before we get soaked.
Hold on. This little thief is fucking with me. You're really pissing me off, you know that? But I'm willing to give you one last chance to make things right. Sing something.
What?
Just pass the audition and you're free. We'll be very upset if you refuse.
Oh my God.
Estrechita, ¿dónde estás? Me pregunto qué serás. En el cielo y en el mar. Un diamante de
Jeez, verdad. Enough!
Let the boy finish his song. Go on. Go on.
Estrechita, ¿dónde estás? Me pregunto qué serás. Cuando el sol se ha ido ya. Cuando nada brilla más. Tú nos muestras tu brillar. Brillas, brillas sin parar. Estrellita, ¿dónde estás? Me pregunto qué serás.
Well, damn! I think you just won Mexican Idol. Now pick up all your shit and get the fuck out. Don't ever come back. Understand?
You'll never see me here again, jerk.
So the Wolf brothers were split apart. The oldest wolf was badly hurt, but nothing could stop the wolf from following his brother's tracks.
sunburn.
Okay. Still a few hours away from Haven Point. Almost there.
Looks like he got sunburn on his arms and face and all that. That stuff sucks.
Shit, I need a break. Might be some shade at the next billboard. Stop. Can't run for miles in this heat.
No moving fast. Got it. Well, I can't. I can't do it very long.
Yes. Shade. Oh, man. My feet are killing me. Feels like hiking in hell. Shit. My throat feels like sand. Never drew a desert before. Huh.
It's so empty and quiet. You get to kind of see how the drawing is affected by his one eye. If it's affected very much.
Got a good picture of it. I'm ready to draw now. Okay, just draw now. Don't think about anything else. This place is so empty. At least I won't mess up perspective for once. I guess that's an okay start. But I can keep going. Got a good picture of it. I'm ready to draw now. Okay, just draw now. Don't think about anything else. Guess I could spice things up a bit. Make the whole thing funnier.
Why not?
I could try adding details. Focus a bit more. Got a good picture of it. I'm ready to draw now. Man.
Love it.
My eye always starts hurting when I focus for too long.
I don't think... Yeah, there's nothing else. I drank water. I did the drawing, so time to get back up.
Daniel better be okay. Feels like I haven't seen him in years. Of course I miss everything about him. Even his whining. Was that? Huh. Well, at least I got company.
Coyote. It's either a coyote or a dingo, but I'm pretty sure it's a coyote. I'm pretty sure dingoes are, like, Australia specifically.
Don't worry about your feet. Just pace yourself.
My bad.
Oh, shit, there's a truck coming.
Whoa.
Is he honking at me?
He's stopping.
Okay, be cool. Just see what he wants.
I would play caution. I think this guy's okay, but I don't remember.
Truckers can't be cops. Right.
Hey, need a lift? It's too damn hot to be walking.
I think I've gotten in before and it was okay, so I want to try to do it again, but I'm gonna kick myself if I'm wrong.
Yeah, thanks. Hold up.
Truckers aren't terrible.
Jeez, what the hell happened to you?
Nothing, just a bad day. Bad week.
I see. You're not the only one.
Hey, Anton. You there? Everything all right?
Yeah, what's up?
GPS tells me you parked in the middle of nowhere. Just wanted to know what happened.
I had to make a shit stop. Over.
Too much information, but 10-4.
You mean number two.
You owe me a beer for that. Over and out.
Don't freak out. I wouldn't have picked you up if I cared about that hitchhiking law.
Okay. Cool.
Hitchhiking law. Forget this kind of a thing.
So, you hungry or what? You look hungry.
I am. Thank you.
As you heard, my name's Anton. It is good, huh? My wife packs the best sandwiches. Messy.
Best sandwich ever. Seriously, thanks, sir.
Anton.
Anton. Right.
Thanks, Anton.
What's your destination?
Haven Point. You've heard of it?
Oh yeah. Straight ahead, about an hour. Take a nap if you want. You don't have to stay awake to be nice. Hey, don't worry, kid. I'm not a fucking weirdo. Just a boring trucker.
Anton, thank you. Thank you. I'm so glad I remembered that you were sweet. I think the last time when I made the choice, it was one of those things where I was like, I don't want to keep walking like this forever.
Last stop, Haven Point.
Thank you so much.
You just be careful out here. These people are kind of weird.
Really? Okay.
10-4, good buddy.
Thanks, Anton.
Hope those people are caring Christians, like our grandparents.
Yeah, well...
You okay now? Is it gone?
I think.
Good. Scoot back inside now.
Okay, Dad.
Hello there. Is everything all right?
Yeah. Don't worry.
You here for the service?
Yeah, I am. But it's my first time.
Don't be shy. Everybody's welcome here. No matter who you are or where you're from. In his eyes, we are all equal. Plus, we have a pretty nice spread after the service. Stay as long as you want.
Okay, thanks.
Don't thank me. I'm just a vessel for our reverend. Thank her. Looks like you're here to see our new miracle, right?
Sure, of course.
Of course. So many new faces are coming to see him these days. He'll be here any minute now. Just come inside and see for yourself. Praise the Lord.
He's a new miracle. Yeah. I bet you can work it out. But if you can't, you're going to find out.
Poor little girl. Oh, feel that cold air. Oh, thank God for AC.
Picnic with Daniel?
What's going on?
Reverend Fisher and new disciple Daniel for a private picnic.
The world is in trouble.
Claire had pretty much the same ones. Cute. They take care of people. Maybe they need it.
Run by greed and technology. Do you think we're any smarter?
Well, I paid for it.
Look at the world. Why do we bow to these machines and ignore the real creator? Why? Temptation, not salvation. It can seduce you and destroy your faith. I know you understand.
didn't
want to
go out there with all those people.
Shit. I will draw too much attention. Better try upstairs.
But the path of salvation has never been easy.
Faith. We hear that word a lot. But faith is not just a word, my brothers and sisters. Oh, no. What is faith? Remember Luke 18:27. What is impossible for man is possible for God. Amen. With that righteous faith comes the salvation of your souls. Can you cross that invisible bridge to salvation?
Yes.
Do you want your soul to be saved, brothers and sisters?
Yes.
Oh, yes. You are not like all these sinners out there. So I never asked the Lord for a sign. Then he gave me one. He spoke to me and told me that I was doing right. And to reward our great faith, the Lord sent me the ultimate gift. An angel. A child graced with the power of God. The miracle we have all been praying for, waiting for. Can I get a hallelujah? Do you have faith in his power? Do you have faith in me? Then please welcome our newest member and our latest miracle, the angel Daniel.
Praise you, Daniel.
Here is Daniel.
Oh, praise be
the
Daniel.
Prophet who was thrown to the lions by false prophets. But God saved Daniel so he could do his work.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yes, Daniel was brought to me to deliver us,
praise
to guide us from the wilderness to our destiny. Now Daniel will reveal the true power of the Lord. A messenger. Our flock keeps growing. I see more and more new faces. But this is only the beginning. You must spread the word. Bear witness to this miracle. Thank you so much for coming. And God bless all of you. Amen.
As our Reverend said, we do appreciate your kind donations.
This helps us keep our church and to spread the word of God. Oh yeah, there's only a few tickets left for our picnic raffle next Sunday. Don't miss the child and another miracle. Any questions, please talk to me outside. Bless you for coming today.
Yeah. Gonna be hard to get him away from this.
Hi.
Oh, hi.
I saw you out in that parking lot earlier.
Yep, that was me.
I like to be here, too. We can see the whole room, and it's where our Reverend Mother teaches us classes.
Whoa. You okay? Need some water?
No, sorry. I'm just kind of sick.
Oh, that sucks. That's too bad.
Hey, what happened to your eye?
Well, that's a long story.
That's okay. My name is Sarah Lee. What's yours?
Hello, Sarah Lee. My name is Sean. Good to meet you. By the way, can I ask you something?
You are Daniel's brother? Really? He's always talking about you.
Hey, not too loud. Yes, I'm Daniel's brother, but I need some help.
The Reverend Mother says we always have to help our neighbor. What do you need?
Who is this Reverend?
You don't know her? That's our Mother Lisbeth. She was blessed by the hand of God when she was my age. She can't ever sin. The Lord guides her.
What is this place?
This is our home. Our church and community. The Reverend Mother says we are all chosen by God.
What is Daniel doing here?
He's our miracle. And the Lord brought him right to our Reverend Mother. I like him. He's really kind and funny. We play together all the time.
So, can you take me to Daniel?
Oh, yes. He's gonna be so happy when he sees you. He missed you so much for his birthday. It will be like a late surprise.
Daniel, you're the living proof of their faith. And mine. I know you understand.
I guess... I mean... Sean?
Oh, my...
Sean! You came back! I knew it!
You've grown up, Inanna.
Do I look older? What? What happened to your eye?
Don't worry. It's okay.
Did that happen at the farm? Because of... me? I'm so sorry. I'm sorry.
It's over, Daniel. We just gotta walk on.
Does it hurt?
No. Not as much as your haircut.
Shut up. It's different. I kinda like it. Sean. I didn't want to leave you there. Nothing I could do. I was so scared. I even thought you were dead. And...
It's okay. We're together now.
Yes. So, are you gonna stay with us now? Huh?
We still need to go to Puerto Lobos.
But... we don't need to. We have a new home now. Look.
One step at a time, Daniel. Give Sean a chance to process this. I'm sure this is all so overwhelming. By the way, my name is Lisbeth Fisher. We all prayed for your safe return. Sean, you must be a believer now in our Lord, too.
Kinda.
Daniel told me you had faith. That's how you got here. But first, I need Sarah Lee and Daniel to grab the medicine kit. We have to take care of our new guest. This is a place of healing.
Aww. Let's do it later. I want to talk to him now.
Daniel? Now.
Okay, Reverend Mother.
Let's go, Daniel.
Whoa, whoa. Hold on.
Well, Sean, it's a pleasure to meet you. This is a real blessing today. You were away from Daniel for quite a while.
I was in a coma.
Of course. I wasn't judging you. So what is your plan, Sean? This is a blessed family, and it would be good for Daniel to have you by his side. You should know that the Lord has big plans for him.
Maybe I could stay here for a while.
You know, I am impressed by your drive and devotion. But small is the gate and narrow the way.
What is that supposed to mean?
I've heard everything about your journey, Sean. And I cannot let a sinner like you into my community. Not until you make penance.
What? Are you serious?
I'm sorry, my son.
I'm not your son. And Daniel isn't gonna be your golden cow. Daniel! Come on!
Why don't we ask him what he wants to do?
Do not touch me!
Ouch.
What the fuck?
What did you do?
Nothing.
Enough. You spilled blood in the Lord's home.
Sean! What happened?
Your brother came in here, impure and acting like a criminal. But he can be saved, Daniel.
I'm sorry, Sean. She's right. I will pray for you. Then, when you're ready, we can.
She's trying to manipulate you.
Let me lead you to the one true light that never goes out. I want to be your friend.
You're crazy! Let's get out of here, Daniel.
I want to stay. Just go.
There's your answer, Sean.
We're together again. So we can go, right?
Come on.
Get off me, dude! What? Daniel! Let me go, asshole! Daniel! They're not your family!
Stop it.
You just need to have faith. We'll be waiting.
Daniel!
It's okay, Sean!
Daniel!
There you go. Satisfied? Now don't you ever come back! Come on, kid. Don't make me do this. You're not gonna win.
Just getting up. Dude, goodness.
Daniel! Daniel!
You're pissing me off. This is private property. I have a legal right to stop any intruders like you.
I just want my brother.
But he doesn't want you. He was brought here, and this is where he's staying. Next time, I will not hesitate to use this. Now get out of here.
Daniel, hey! Daniel.
Sean?
Karen?
You won't get him back like this. Let's go.
Mm-hmm. Did that say Happy Easter? Karen's their mom, in case anybody forgot.
Sean, what happened to your eye?
Why the hell are you here? How did you find me?
Well, I got a letter from Jacob. He said you were missing, and that Daniel needed help. I believed him.
So you finally decided to check on him.
You know, Sean, sooner or later, we're gonna have to talk.
Where are we even going?
I already have a hotel room. You're gonna need to rest and clean that dressing.
Looks like closed. Is that a wolf on his shirt?
Man. Didn't clean the paint away, but... Okay. That felt good.
I was gonna laugh. I was gonna be like, I swear. He just happens to find wolf clothes. Which is funny.
Wonder how long Karen has been here. Did she see one of Daniel's... This country is just... way too big. Karen was always into low-tech. I even think it's the one she had back then.
One of those people that doesn't need the newest stuff all the time, or doesn't really care.
You've come a long, long way, buddy. This thing is killing my back.
I'm messing with my peppermint.
I got bruises on my bruises.
Got myself some peppermints for Christmas, and so... Okay, let's see what we got here. So this is... Grandparents' letter, Chris Cassidy. Brody's letter. Can't believe this lasted this long. The etch sketch got broke. Aww. Yeah, there's a lot in here, but... It's not as easy to, like, read out the stuff as it is in the other games, so... right.
Huh. This isn't her tablet. Yay, technology. She came prepared.
Welcome to your new life at the Universal Uprising Church, Haven Point. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. Matthew 28:19-20. Mission. Accept the Lord, spread the word of Jesus, keep faith with the community, to seek and save the lost. Luke 19:10. Mm-hmm. As the pastor of our holy church, I have devoted my life and love to the teachings of the gospel and our Lord. I was blessed since childhood to be given this calling, and it is my privilege to spread the word and preside over this loving, righteous community of Haven Point. I look forward to meeting each and every one who seeks out our humble refuge. Together we will begin the journey to a new life guided by the Spirit of the Lord and Savior. Bless you all. Haven Point, Nevada is a living oasis where individuals and families can live out their faith in a community dedicated to the teachings of Christ. All who share our faith are welcome to join us, build a bridge to the Lord and his eternal estate. Mm-hmm.
Reverend Mother doesn't look too humble.
One of the great mysteries of Nevada is how it balances the Holy Spirit with the holy dollar. Few tourists travel from around the world to seek religion here, but in the tight-knit Christian community of Haven Point, Nevada, the charismatic pastor has inspired a devout following. As she told me in an interview at her peaceful church office, Reverend Lisbeth Fisher has spent her whole life as a humble disciple of the Lord, feeling the call to share his love and glory in this dark age. I had a powerful experience as a child that put me on the righteous path. She smiles gently and touches my hand. But this is not about me or my story, as anybody in our world, wonderful church can tell you. And tell me they did. The members of the Universal Uprising Church speak with hushed awe of their pastor and how she inspires them. Reverend Fisher just wants to share her blessings with us, says Corey Johnson, 34, a recent addition to the congregation. I was pretty cynical before I went to one of her revivals. You could feel the electricity when she spoke. People were crying, including me.
Looks like a roach motel.
Beds are super uncomfortable, but it's cheap, nice, cool, but dusty.
Nobody will find me there.
Dang right. A little souvenir? Yeah.
Be right back. We'll find out.
Popped out for supplies. I'll grab some food in case you want to eat. New socks and shorts in the bathroom, all yours if they fit. Might be a good time to contact Jacob. His number is on the letter he sent. Be right back, Karen.
Jeez. It only took Supermom 8 years to give a shit.
Dear Miss Diaz, my name is Jacob and I worked with your sons, Sean and Daniel, on a farm in California. There were some problems and Sean went missing. I'm with Daniel now in Haven Point, Nevada. He gave me this P.O. box address, so if you get this, I think Daniel might be in danger. He needs help to get out of here. I can tell you more if you contact me at this number, 775-555-0118. Please hurry. Thank you, Jacob. All right.
Karen was always into low-tech. I even think it's the one she had back then.
Oh, I can't call Jacob. Oh, I probably have to use this phone, huh?
Hello?
Jacob, it's me, Sean.
Sean? So you found
your sketchbook?
Yeah.
Where are you? You have to come here, Sean.
I know. I'm not far. In a motel.
Good. Listen, I can't talk right now. I gotta go.
Wait! Daniel, how's he doing?
Meet me tomorrow afternoon on Brandy Highway. There's a junction just above Haven Point. There's a wild mice ranch billboard there. I'll be there at 4.
Jacob, wait!
I can't talk, Sean. Be there tomorrow. Please.
All right.
Damn. He couldn't really talk. All this is so messed up. So Karen did check it out. Wonder if she saw Daniel in action. Kinda pretty. Wonder if she made it. I know I shouldn't peek, but whatever. Damn. Karen does like to capture the world around her.
Tracing closer every mile, my heart goes racing, sore. I remember, know the feeling. There's no fighting back that beating, tearing apart my core. Early morning blues, coffee, red-eyed truckers and sad families. Bad eggs, not the waitress's fault. She is a quick, hurried one, probably ending a long night shift. Tag says Clementine, 22-ish, redhead-dyed brunette. Eyebrows and skin tone don't lie, Irish descent. Owner's daughter, maybe, Mahoney's. Vague, polite smile, busy mind. Mildly clumsy, lips distracted. Anxious? Young cook called her Clemmy. Brother? Boyfriend. Apologizes when the orders are late and she's the one getting roasted. Do mom and dad know you're dating on the job, Clemmy? Mixing up work and love seldom makes a good batch. That a brand new baby bump under the stained apron? It's 2017 and young folks are still busy making babies. I guess nothing ever really changes.
Karen did her own road trip to get here. Glad to know she learned the lesson. Damn. You look bad. Gotta change that dressing soon.
To do it now.
Karen seems to be on the move quite often.
I was wondering if I could, you know, clean the eye and all that now, but I guess not. Okay. We just gotta wait for her then.
Let's just rest while I wait for her. If she comes back.
Hey, sorry it took so long. Fucking store was packed. How you feeling? Nothing broken? Altar boys don't fight fair.
Yeah. I'm okay.
Double cheese, no onion, right?
That'll do.
The burger sounds so good right now.
Got you some gauze and antibacterial stuff for your eye. Hey, don't wolf that down. Or at least take a breath.
Like you care.
Sean, I do.
Come on, Karen.
Don't act all hurt. It's too late. Where were you when I broke my leg when I was 13? Not with me. When Daniel got a bad flu a couple years ago, you didn't sleep next to him every night. Where were you? Where were you?
Fair enough. So let's talk, because we do have to get your brother out of a cult.
I'm listening.
How did you two survive alone on the road for that long?
We just got lucky. And got some help along the way. Total strangers. We even had our own little family.
Good. How did you go to Beaver Creek?
You know I don't have to answer your questions, right?
You're right. So tell me what you want from me, Sean.
Nothing, Karen. I mean, what do you want from me? A fucking hug?
Hey, I just want you to know what I did. And why. If you care. So, ask me anything.
All right. Why did you bail on us?
I wasn't meant to be a wife or a mother. I thought I was supposed to. I tried to pretend for many years. But I was unhappy, and the urge to leave just became unbearable.
You weren't happy with your own kids?
I had no other choice.
Are you serious? You chose this life. You fell in love. You made your own choices, right?
Making your own choices doesn't mean you can never fool yourself, Sean. After I had Daniel, you were about 8, and Esteban's garage was getting busy. There was so much going on around me, yet somehow I just felt that my own life was just slipping away. Felt like an empty shell. Sean, it was the hardest decision I ever made. I knew I might never see you all again, but I took that responsibility.
So you just dumped us so you could be free?
Yes. That's exactly what I did.
You're just so fucking selfish. So what exactly are you doing in Nevada? You live around here?
No. I'm way out in Arizona. Sean, I told you. Your friend Jacob wrote my P.O. box and said Daniel was in trouble. That's it.
Arizona? Holy shit. It's just lizards and rocks.
Yes, I found something there. New York didn't really do me good, so...
Yeah, okay. Think I've heard enough.
I didn't have a choice, Sean.
We you
only
have
had one life. And I didn't want mine to be spent in regrets. For years, I fooled myself.
Your
thinking
children
I'd find satisfaction into what society expected me to be, and that was my mistake. I hope someday you can understand that. But I never stopped caring about you. For what it's worth, I am sorry for hurting you and Daniel and Esteban.
I know you are, Karen. That still doesn't change the way I feel.
Of course not. I know I can't change the past, Sean.
I don't think you would. I need some air.
Sean, Whatever you want to say to me, this is the time. Let's just get it all out in the open. See what happens.
I mean, I get you wanted to leave and stuff, okay? But why would you ghost us like that? Not even a fucking birthday card.
I thought if I vanished, you would all move on. But I wanted to contact you guys so many times. I almost did.
But you wanted a clean break from us.
I didn't want to be a part-time, pissed-off mother. Not fair to any of you. I left when Daniel was still very young, so he wouldn't remember me.
Cool plan, Mom. You hurt Daniel way worse. He thought you took off because of him.
I know. I hope I can make it up to you, Daniel, someday. I can start by getting his ass out of that church. Cult. Whatever.
So, what did you do when you left? Where did you go?
I pursued some dreams and failed. Learned the lessons. I guess all this time I tried to find out what really matters to
me. Which doesn't involve a husband and two kids.
It does to a lot of people, and I totally respect that. Just not to me. I wasn't good at making plans, which is what most of modern life is about, right? School, job, marriage. Ask my mom and dad. They wanted me to follow their rules, their faith. Oof, I tried, but I wanted to find my own way, with no security blanket. Family, religion, social norms. It's just all about security, after all. But it all just looked like a sweet golden jail to me. I tried to escape that.
You just sound immature, like a kid running away from home.
You're right. I do. But I think people should know who they are, and not fake it for anybody.
So, did you ever actually miss us? Or Dad?
Of course, Sean. I do miss your father. He had such a big heart. He could brighten up a rainy day. That was like his superpower. But above all, I missed watching you grow up. See how you saw the world. I missed sharing these moments with you, Sean.
We used to do so much stuff. Like when you taught me to ride because Dad sucked. Or when we went camping near Vancouver. Just me and you.
You always loved night skies.
I did stargaze a lot when I was in California.
Trust me, the further south you go, the better it gets.
Whatever. You sound so careless. It's like you can't even realize how much pain you've caused.
I do care. It's why I'm here. To help you and your brother. If I didn't step up to help him now, I couldn't live with myself.
Hey, mind if I bum a smoke?
Sure. Still got a few left. Wow. I haven't seen that lighter in ages. Your Dad loved that thing.
I know. Only thing I have left of his.
No, man. Esteban hated when I smoked. He didn't want me to die an early death. Fuck. Life can be so cynical sometimes.
I remember he would smoke sometimes. Long ago.
We didn't fight much. But when we did, I would go out on the porch and light up so I could calm down. Esteban would come over and ask for a drag. Then we'd just look up at the sky and watch the stars or the planes. I do miss that.
I used to do the same thing with my best friend, Lila. Smoking on the porch, just letting time go.
That's when you know someone is good to you. When you can just sit together. Shut the hell up and watch the universe do its own thing.
We should go back inside. I gotta change this dressing.
Okay. Let's go. Sean, I know I can't change the past. Or what I did. But this is about helping your brother. You gotta trust me this one time.
I know. It's still hard. But yes. We have to be a team to rescue Daniel.
We can do it.
Okay. How?
We need to get in touch with this Jacob. He obviously knows a lot more than us about the church.
Well, I called him when you were out. We can meet with him tomorrow.
Okay, good. I also got these, just in case.
Okay. Better take care of the eye.
So, do you need any help with that?
Yes. Thanks.
So, you feel like telling me the story here?
When we have time.
Gotcha.
Funny, they'll show like bruises on bodies and stuff like that, but the eye socket injury is always the one they were just like casually avoiding putting on the screen. Not that I'd want to see it anyway, but it always makes me laugh a little. Inside, at least.
Here, try this on.
Eye patch. There you go.
How do I look?
Great.
Thank you, Karen.
Big day tomorrow, so we should get some rest.
Yeah. I'm ready to get Daniel.
Bless me. Dang.
Sure he's gonna show up?
He better. He promised.
Well, if he doesn't find us, we'll find him. I can't believe how much crap you guys have been through. Makes me want to punch in the face each and every asshole that got in your way.
Yeah. Good thing we got to meet amazing people, too.
Life on the road is all about that. The sweet encounters.
Hope I can see them again someday.
Oh, you will. So tell me about Daniel. What's he like?
Well, he's definitely special.
Hope so. He's your brother, right? Heads up. Is that him?
Yep. Wait here.
Pick up.
Sean! What happened?
Jake, I'm not mad, but you better explain everything.
I didn't know where else to go. Listen, I saw Daniel come back to the camp that night. Like, he was in shock or something. Then I heard all these sirens, and I got scared. I packed a few things, I took a blanket from your tent, and we left together. I also kept the cash you made on the farm. It's in my car.
You did right, Jake. Thank you.
You have no idea what he looked like when I found him that night, Sean. He was in bad shape, with a gunshot wound, and all by himself. I couldn't just leave him there.
What about the others? Hannah, Penny, what happened to them?
They ran over to Merrill's place when they found out Finn and Cass were gone. That was the last time I saw them. Then on our way out here, Daniel told me more about what happened that night. How scared he was. The blast. Daniel feels he's gotta redeem himself for what he did.
I need to get to him, Jacob. He's not guilty of anything. I should have protected him better.
I'm telling you, to be careful with the Reverend Mother. She's waited her whole life for somebody like Daniel. The Reverend knows how to manipulate people. She's good at this. He wants to stay with her. Daniel has faith in the Reverend now.
Yeah, not afraid of that Lisbeth of yours. I'm getting Daniel out of here.
Come on. There's no way they're gonna let you take him away.
Well, too bad. We're not gonna ask for their permission. You must be Jacob. I'm Karen. Hi.
Okay. I don't know if you want to do this, but I have an idea. I think school must be over by now. But Lisbeth will stay at the church with Daniel for his special classes. That'll give us time to sneak into the compound before we get to them.
I'll be on the lookout. Keep watch in case it all goes to shit. Sean, stay on the walkie.
Sounds like a plan.
One more thing. We have to get my sister, too. Sarah Lee.
Really, Jacob? Come on, man. She's with your parents.
I know. Please, listen, Sean. She's not safe here. She's sick. They believe in everything Lisbeth says. And she says she'll cure Sarah with prayers. I know you understand, right?
Damn, Jake.
We need his help too, Sean.
Okay, Jake. I'm listening.
Lisbeth knows what's wrong with Sarah Lee. We need to find her medical record. I think it's in her home office. Then I'll go get Sarah Lee while you get Daniel. Okay?
Fine.
Sure.
I'm gonna trust you on this, Jacob. All good for you, Karen.
What if Daniel won't go with you?
He will. I know him.
All right. Time to go try to save Daniel.
Karen?
I'm in place. I can see the whole camp. Let me know if you need anything. Be careful, Sean.
Got it. Thanks.
We gotta be careful now. If anything happens, let me do the talking, okay?
Yeah, of course. Let's get this over with.
Okay. Elizabeth's house is right behind the church, so in and out.
Okay. And you sure Lisbeth will have those files on your sister?
Watch out, Sean. There are people right outside.
Oh, shit. How many?
Just three. A man with his kid on one side, and a woman alone on the other.
Got it. Thanks.
People aren't supposed to come and go around the church once the service is over. Better to avoid them if we can.
Karen, everything all right?
Yeah, don't worry about me. I found the best hiding spot. The view is kind of great.
Cool. Be careful, though. You never know.
Thanks, Sean. I will.
They're behind the building since she's sitting right in front of the building.
So, did you grow up out of here?
No. In another community back east. When Elizabeth came out here to start Haven Point, my folks followed her and brought me along.
Hmm. Must have been hard on you.
Kinda. 8-year-olds don't want to go to church all day. Okay. There it is. Looks empty.
Let's hope so.
Luckily for us, we never close our door. Closed door, is it?
Can't believe Daniel really lives in this depressing house.
Oh, we did it. Now we have a little bit more time.
Yes, we do. Nice work. So where are the files?
Right there, in her office. Oh, of course it's locked. Her open door speech is just another lie. We gotta find a way in.
Fuck. Think there's a key somewhere?
Maybe she's too cautious not to have a spare set around. Whoa.
The evenings in here must be so much fun. Are you okay, Jake?
Yeah. Yeah, no. It's just so full of memories and stuff.
It's seriously been a while since I've been through any of this. Search the door.
Whoa. They kicked her out of church? Now they're thirsty.
From Michael Bloom to Elizabeth Fisher sent, Dear Reverend Fisher, this is Michael Bloom, and I know it's been a long time since we last talked, and I know that our talk was not a happy one. Despite our differences, we all knew you were a devout spirit to be reckoned with. Nobody has been surprised by your words and deeds touching so many people. I hope you believe it when I say we are all proud of you. But we are also sorry and ashamed for asking you to leave the church without understanding the power of your faith. As we need to remind ourselves, mistakes can be life lessons. Even prideful deacons should be humbled before the Lord's wisdom. We hope you find it in your heart to forgive us, and we would be honored to host you for a visit anytime you wish. Bless you, Michael. So she got kicked out of her last,
Don't see anything of interest.
Cigarettes?
Oh, shit. Looks like the Reverend Mother got this letter before Jake.
Jacob, thank you so much for telling me about Daniel. I'm on my way to Haven Point now, and please let Daniel know, without getting him or you in trouble, that his family has not forgotten him. I don't know where Sean is, and I hope we can find him, too. I hope the best for you, and if you need anything, do not hesitate to ask for help. I'm there. Take care, Karen.
Okay, I found a key.
Good. Let's try it.
Hey, I found your letter for Jacob. Too bad Lisbeth found it first.
She took it from the mail? Damn that woman.
Yeah, she checks everything that comes and goes into the community.
That's crazy, to be checking other people's mail.
Yes, that's the one.
Perfect.
Whoa. Is this her personal archive or something?
Yeah, she keeps track of everything in here. Stuff about my sister must be in this one.
Okay, I've got something. Must be what you're looking for.
Damn. She has pneumonia? And for what I get, Lisbeth knows damn well she needs medical treatment.
That's criminal. She's insane. Look, she has a file on you too.
You can take a peek and see how she really treats her flock.
Man, what's all this? Were you, like, sick? Conversion therapy? Did they...
He was gay.
Wanted to cure you from...
Being gay?
Being...
Pretty much. I always showed more interest in boys than girls. They thought I was a freak. A sinner.
Is that why you ran away?
Yep. Took me 5 years to understand what was up. I was too scared. Confused. I really did believe I was a sinner, so I thought I had to atone for my sins.
Tone. For what sins? I don't get how they can preach this kind of crap. I mean, you met Finn and everyone. Are they sinners then?
Of course not. I just didn't know different, Sean. I believed them.
Damn, Jake.
After a few years, I was in a really bad place. I tried to hurt myself. Elizabeth was very upset. We had a long chat. She told me I should leave. Go see the world and figure things out. I don't really get her, Sean. But Elizabeth does believe in all of this stuff.
I had no clue about your life here. I'm sorry, Jake.
I'm sorry I brought Daniel here. I was just... so blown away when I saw what he could do. It was like a real miracle. I thought I'd found my faith again. Instead, I just hurt him.
Then let's make things right. We just have to get Daniel out of here.
I hope so. And I'll get my sister to a hospital. Have her treated. I hope they'll help her.
Keep our money. For your sister. She needs it.
Oh, I can't do that, Sean. That's a lot of...
We're okay. It will cover her medical bills.
Wow. Thank you, Sean.
Sean, are you there?
What's up?
You got company. That thug who works for Elizabeth, he's just holding some files. Doesn't seem to be onto you.
This guy is dangerous, Sean.
Hey,
trust me.
I have a good plan to get him out of your way. He'll give you more time. Just give me the word.
Yeah. See what you can do.
I will. Get ready.
Sean, we gotta hide. Now. Hurry up. Come on, Sean, we need to hide.
I'm already hiding.
Man, if he finds us here, we're screwed.
Weird. Better tell Elizabeth about this. What the fuck is going on?
Shit. I mean...
Sean.
Oh, well.
Do you think...
It's gotta be Karen.
Oh, he's gone. Let's get out of here. Oh, man, that was crazy. I really thought he was gonna catch us.
The guy's leaving. Looks like my diversion worked out.
Yeah. Nice job.
Don't waste time searching for anything else, just get out.
Look at that. Your mom is hardcore, Sean.
Yeah. I guess she is.
The fire?
So we're all good now?
At the church?
I'll go get Sarah Lee while you get Daniel. Then let's meet up at the car, okay?
All right. You be careful, okay?
You too, Sean. Good luck.
We got this. Let's go. That's one crazy idea for a distraction.
Come in, Karen. See anything?
No, you're all clear.
Awesome. Talk later.
So you know what you're gonna do?
No. But let's do it.
Oh, Lord. Let your power speak through this young vessel. I am your humble
Sean,
servant and will obey your every command. Speak to me.
It's Daniel.
Speak.
I told you, he's kind of special.
Hey.
Sean! You came back?
Enano. Little cub. Come with me, Daniel. We're leaving.
I'm sorry, Sean. I can't.
She's full of shit, dude. And she's using you.
Daniel has made his choice, Sean.
But I'm offering you to join us again. Put your faith in me, and you'll be family.
Never!
So that's your final decision. May the Lord have mercy on your lost soul. It's time for you to leave our sanctuary, right now.
Not without my brother.
I'm not going anywhere. This is my home. She's my family now.
Daniel, listen. She's not your family.
Sean, who is she?
Our mother. She came here. For you.
Oh, praise the Lord. Another miracle at our church. Wonderful. It's all right, Daniel. Go see her. I mean, she's right there. Don't be afraid.
I don't know her.
Of course. I know. This is hard for you, my son.
Stop calling him that. You're just manipulating him, you sicko.
That's in the eye of the beholder. But since you are his mother, let me ask you. How could you let your child wander alone in the wilderness? Where were you when Daniel was lost? Where?
Listen, Daniel. I came here as soon as I found out you were here on your own.
I'm not on my own.
Children are a gift from the Lord. They are a reward from Him. You were blessed with a divine gift. And you cast him out into the world.
Who the hell are you?
You might have been his mother once, but when you abandoned him, you also gave up your rights.
Isn't your God all about forgiveness?
You have no idea what the Bible says. How can you pretend to care about these two children? You left them and your husband to seek out your base desires.
Daniel, honey, she's trying to trick you. Please, think by yourself. You're smarter than this.
Daniel, she's responsible for what happened to your father.
You don't know anything.
No, she's not.
It was an accident. That's what this world is about. Accidents, injustice, pain.
I'm just so sorry, Daniel.
I know. I know how much I hurt you and your brother by leaving. I know that's not enough, but I hope we can talk about this together. That's what I've been trying to tell your brother, and I'm so glad he listened. You gotta trust us. She's using you for her selfish desires.
Daniel, this time the choice is yours. Are you going to believe her or me?
I...
That's right. You can't tempt Daniel from this garden. He'll stay with us, his true family. And we'll never leave him.
Go to hell. Come on, Daniel.
No!
Stop! Holy shit.
Reverend, are you okay?
Nicholas, they're heretics sent to desecrate our church.
Okay, what now?
Don't you understand? This is over, Sean.
You have to talk to him. You can convince him, Sean.
I won't leave you, Daniel. Not here.
Don't be so stubborn, Sean. Your brother chose his path.
Your friend, Sarah Lee? She's very sick. And Lisbeth won't take her to a doctor.
What? She wouldn't do
that.
This
is pointless. Daniel knows who to trust.
Don't listen to her religious bullshit. You need to have faith in yourself, not in her.
But you said heaven and God existed. Why are you lying?
You're right. He's wicked. Unfaithful.
She was kicked out of her previous church. Yeah, they knew she was crazy. So she left and founded Haven Point.
Why would they do that? Did she do something wrong?
Liar! I left on my own because they were all blind. Don't believe his lies, Daniel.
I found a letter from Karen, our mother, inside her house. She hid it from you, so you never know she's looking for you.
What? You told me she didn't want to see me. See what you have done.
Hey, Enano.
Back off.
No one is gonna keep me away from you.
I said stop!
Don't. I came all this way for you, and nobody will stop me. I'll even cross hell or whatever if I need.
Sean!
He must learn.
Listen. I did my best job to be a good brother. And I know I probably failed. I took you for granted. I put you in danger. And I'm sorry.
Sean!
Don't listen to him.
He left you just like that harlot did. Shut him up.
He can hit me as much as he wants. I won't give up on you.
Don't hit him.
Don't let them do that, Daniel.
Get up, Sean.
If I could go back in time, I would. We'd be in our living room in Seattle. That would get us pizza and snacks, then pick the movie, because we would always fight about it. And he always picked your movie. But I can't do that. All I can do now is fight.
Quiet! What are you waiting for?
We're the best team in Anu.
Stop
so
it!
So we have to keep going
no.
forward.
What are
You're
you
gonna
doing?
Kill him!
Please! He's my brother!
You can burn down our church, but not our faith.
Daniel knows you're telling the truth.
Don't give up.
Not giving up. Get up, Sean.
Nothing is gonna stop me, Daniel. We're brothers.
I know.
Dad always said our blood link was the most important thing. You know.
Please! Stop! Leave him alone!
Daniel! Listen to him!
I won't stop! No matter what she does! I'll come right back! Again! And again! I love you, Daniel.
I do too. Shut him up! Now!
Don't move! Just stop!
If you want to kill me, then do it! I'm not afraid!
Do it! Shoot! Don't!
Go ahead!
What?
Shoot me in the face! And live with me.
Now! Stop!
Come on, Daniel.
Daniel! Sean! I'm sorry. I was so confused. I thought she was someone else.
Sit.
I'm sorry.
Sean, we need to get out of here. Now.
Oh, no. No.
You started this fire. You will all burn in this hell.
Move. Let us go. Move it!
You won't leave this place. Not with me alive.
first. No, wait, no, wait a minute. No, wait a minute, no.
Or I will hurt you.
Sean,
foolish child. You can't threaten me with death. I embrace it. I know what awaits me.
Open the door and then.
Daniel, after all I did for you, you can still repent.
I don't believe you anymore! Ugh.
Get out of here. Go. Run. Maybe I'll get some good screenshots. To look over our choices. So we passed one of the tests. Well, I was really close to passing both. If I'd gotten one more try, I would have had the pen done. But we passed one of them. Told Agent Flores the robbery was Finn's idea. Yeah. Escaped the hospital without hurting anyone. There's a 5% of people have been able to convince Joey to help us escape. So I know there's, like, a chance to do it, but I'm pretty sure it's just really hard. We didn't talk to Finn. I guess you could either blame him or forgive him. I assumed if you talked to him, it'd be, like, one of those, you know, he knows you turned him in and admitted he was behind it, and so he would, like, turn you in for trying to escape. I don't know. Broke Daniel's toy while taking it back from Chad. Okay, so if I didn't try to take it back, it wouldn't have broken. Okay, well. Yeah. Sang the song in Spanish. Okay. Yeah. Got into Anton's truck to reach Haven Point. 91% of people get into his truck. That's fair. Gave money to the church. Yeah, I mean, I wanted to get that souvenir. It's one of the collectibles. Overall, you tried to let Karen open up to you. Yeah, I tried. I had a cigarette with Karen, accepted Karen's help to clean the wound. Yep, yep. Nicholas was unaware of your presence. Oh, yeah, yeah. Shared the money with Jacob, so he can help a sister. Managed to hide from Nicholas. You and Daniel both spared Elizabeth's life. Okay. Continue. Oh, did we not get a Daniel's choices this time? Well, I guess he was only in, like, the end of the episode, so I guess technically we don't get
Daniel's
choices.
This is it. We made it, Daniel.
What do we do now?
Make our way across. You ready?
Yeah. I think.
All right. So that is it for episode 4 of Life is Strange 2. This is it, guys. Next week is the final episode of the game. So, I was also thinking, you know, so the games have collector's modes, so you can go through each episode and make your choices and be able to get the collectibles, which is kind of the point of it, but it also means you kind of go through the episodes to make your choices without affecting your overall stats in the game. So I'll probably use that to help with the ending stuff. We'll see how it works out. But with that being said, please remember to like, subscribe, and ring the bell so you don't miss another video, especially if you want to see the finale of Life is Strange 2 and overall the finale of what currently exists in the Life is Strange franchise. Please remember to check out the playlist if you need to go back, binge watch, recap before the ending to all of this. Or if you want to just go back later and rewatch them all, they're all sorted in the playlist, so you're good to go there. Please remember to eat plenty, stay hydrated, get plenty of rest, and above all else, just have a good night. I hope you guys so far are having a good start to 2024. I'm hoping this year will be a better year. We'll see how it goes. But I love y'all. Thank you for being here, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.